Hello, welcome to the flow, everybody. I'm really happy about the flow today because it is based upon love. We're going to flow in the Holy Spirit on love in regards to what the Bible teaches us about love and what God's laws and commandments tell us about love. You know, initially I was watching a YouTube video. I like to watch other Christian, you know, religious counterparts. And there was this gentleman, he was talking about our relationship with God and how to have a better one with God. And, you know, he was telling us, you know, in regards to praying and worshiping and reading your word, which is true. This is true. But ultimately, it's about loving one another, because once you love your neighbor, you're showing an act of God towards God and how to be. So there was one thing he left out that I felt like is an example of your relationship with God. It is similar to your relationship with God. It says, the Bible says, if you love your neighbor as you love yourself and love God with all your mind, body, heart, and soul, like that is the law and the commandments that God gives us. It is the hardest one to do out of all the 10, because, you know, despite life's issues and the things that occur, love has to still exist in some situations that are, you know, hard to do that in when people are angry or unforgiveness is there. Here's the Bible scripture in John 13:34. This is a command, the new command. It says, let me give you a new command. Love one another in the same way I love you. You love one another. This is how everyone will recognize that you are my disciples, when they see the love you have for each other. Simon Peter asked, Master, just where are you going? Jesus answered, you can't now follow me where I'm going. You will follow later. This is where Jesus is telling him he'll be taken up into heaven. But ultimately, he's saying, love one another in the same way that in manner that I love you. Because when you see the act of God from God, you're able to distribute it to others so that it has this effect on others. And you'll see your world, your life, your thoughts, and everything change. Just like in my book, it says, let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. The link is in my bio to purchase it on Instagram at Equipped by God. But just to give you an idea, this book that I wrote, it was with the Holy Ghost. I wrote it in regards to the flow and with the Holy Ghost, flowing with the Holy Ghost, and everything in it, prayer, scriptures, and mechanisms and tools that would change your life. But ultimately, it speaks on love. The mind of Christ is love. Like, everything in the Bible turned around to you having to distribute love to one another. Why do we distribute love to one another? Because you leave an opportunity for Satan to enter into your situations and your relationships, which prevents you from having a better relationship with God. That's why he says, leave your gift at the altar and go deal with the ought you have with your brother. Because if you have an issue with your brother, how can you come to God whom you have not seen? You know, if you come to God with issues, even the Lord's Prayer, it says, you know, forgive us of our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And it is a very hard thing. It was a hard lesson, you know, for me to learn forgiveness. But I saw that the forgiveness, people always say, it's for you and not them. It is. It's for you. It's like they said, it's like drinking a poison and waiting on the other person to fall dead. You have to learn forgiveness. And forgiveness, it comes with love. Love is forgiveness. It overrides it. It says, love, it covers a multitude of sins. That is what love is. That is what forgiveness is. And that's what the Bible teaches us to have. I know it's like, oh, practice what you preach. But no, we're normal. We're human beings, and not every situation is going to end in love, but the Bible teaches us to love. And that's how you have a relationship with God, or a better one, so to speak. Even the Bible said, it said, for, you know, I was hungry and you did not feed me. I was thirsty and you did not give me a drink. God was saying, even if you didn't do this to those, you did not do it to me. And you should see other people as God. You should see them as someone to distribute or show who God is, because that is what can lead you down the path of knowing God better and having a better relationship with God. Here in Colossians 3, it talks about love and, you know, what Christ demanded for us in regards to love. I want to read this verses 1 through 14. It's long, but it gives you an idea of what love looks like. You know, we try to figure out love in relationships with one another, whether it's friendship, marriage, relationship with the opposite sex or the same sex. But there are situations that will occur, long suffering, you know, issues of life, malice, lying, cheating, stealing. How do you go beyond the thought of what the mind thinks and think like Christ and try to bring love into the situation to remove the sin? Because the result of most of those is murder, you know, anger, fighting, you know, rage, riots, whatever, you know, war. But if you turn it around, what could come of that? And sometimes, most of the time, the things that God works in is things that our natural mind can't think. You know, it's like, who could give such a forgiveness? Who could give such a love? You know, chapter 3, Colossians, in ye then be risen with Christ. Seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. This is where I was telling you to have the mind of Christ, have a mind outside of your natural thinking. You know, even those situations that have you like angry, like I just want, you know what I'm saying? Try to figure out, try to see the good in it all, because God says all things work out for the good of those that love the Lord. For ye are dead and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil conspicuance, and covetousness, which is idolatry, for which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience. Disobedience is another part of your relationship with God, and having obedience with God gives you more of a close relationship with him as well as others. In thee which ye also walked sometimes when ye lived in them, when you were in those sins. But now ye also put off all things, anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. Where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian, bond nor free, but Christ is all and in all. Put on therefore as the elect of God, holy and beloved, bowels of mercy, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another, forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. And above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness. This is love. This is speaking of love. It's speaking of how to do love. You know, it says put off anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not to one another, seeing that you have put off the old man. And you know, God says that behold, all things become new. Your mind becomes new. Your heart becomes new. Those things that you say becomes new to others, because you begin to think outside of yourself and think from another person's perspective. I love the way when you get saved and you begin to read the Bible and you begin to fellowship with other believers, you begin to think from a different perspective, and it changes the way you think, and it changes the way you move, per se. It changes the way you act towards other people, and that changes your life, because it brings happiness, joy, and peace into your life, and you're able to change the direction in which you were going. You know, if you go down an evil path and you begin to let's say quarrel or fight or, you know, do things of that nature, that leaves you into the consequences of those things. But if you go down the road in the acts of love, you receive the blessing and favor of God, and he's able to multiply everything out of your obedience and your sacrifice towards him, because it is a sacrifice to show love to someone who does not deserve it. But God's grace is sufficient for thee, you know? So I just wanted to tell you guys that today, acts of love give you a closer relationship with God. It's obedience, and you'll have a closer relationship with others, and you'll see a move of God, a manifestation of God. If you let no one disqualify you in this Christian walk, you'll be able to put on your new self and be alive in Christ. Much love. Be blessed. Until next time, thank you guys for joining into the flow. It was a blessing to be here today. Peace and blessings.